Darian out here today didn't do a whole lot, but is it still good enough to play on Saturday?
Well, and not to, you know, demean a situation or bring it up, but it is a game time decision, and I really mean that. He did a little bit today. Last week there was more rest days in between for him. So, like I said, there was a lot of positives in it, that it is the same team. And we're playing them back, and then there is a chance for him to get a little bit more rest. And he did enough today to where, you know, he made it through and he got the reads that he needed. So if he is playing, if it doesn't swell up and do all those other things, we'll probably see him on game day.
So if he feels as good as you did today, he'd be the starter on Saturday?
Well, I think he needs to feel a little bit better than today. Like I said, that's why we didn't ask him to do much. But like I said, it'd be a game time deal to where, you know, depending on how he feels, because I think that'll be 6 days, and I don't think he practiced till 6 days last week, so we'll see how he feels.
What have you thought of Drew Willie's reps in practice?
Well, you know, I think both of the young guys are doing some good things. You know, when you look at practice is one thing, but at the end of the day, you know, it's good to see those guys in game-type action, because that's when you really know what you got. You know, last week I didn't think we practiced that well, and I would have never predicted that score to be the way it was. So practice is not always an indicator.
Because it's a game-time decision, would you almost rather he didn't practice at all today?
Well, I always want to practice, because, like I said, if he does, there's some new reason, new things that we put in that he needed to see. Like I said, there's a little bit carryover for next week from last week, but there's some things that he needed to see. Brack's pretty good with it. He's still learning some of the small details of the position, but I think he likes it. I will tell you, I've been teasing the last couple of days. I was like, Brack, when we take you out the safety position and put Butts in, Butts get a pick. When we take you out and put Newman in, Newman gets the sack. So, but he always says he set the guys up for it. So he's the sacrificial lamb, and he's a true team player. But it's just funny when he's not in there, something good happens. But he does a good job for us.
What compelled you to make that change with him?
Well, you know, I think Brack has a lot of good things for us. Like I say, he and Butts, they're kind of evenly matching some areas, but it just allows us to do some things in coverage. And the other thing is Brack with his eyes, he's one of those that where, you know, he's probably more a zone corner when he played down south, and he loved to look at that quarterback a lot, and he's very smart. So he communicates well, and he gets those guys lined up.
This foot injury for Durant, is this something he's dealt with before in his career?
I'm not sure what his prior injuries were, but you know, at this point right now, like I said, it's an injury that's getting better, and I think the bye week helps him and all that rest to where we can pretty soon hopefully have 100% healing there.
With Butler and Brackenridge and Newman, and are you seeing the opposition be as confused as you want them to be?
You know, I think before, you know, we're doing some good things with that. And, you know, like anything else in the CFL, next week or two, a couple of other guys, a couple of other teams may be doing the same thing. We really hadn't even gotten in depth of what we really want to yet. I just think right now we have some good cover guys and some good guys that are just doing a good job. I don't think so much confusion at this point. I think the guys are just doing a good job covering.
What kind of differences have you seen in Chris Melo's approach maybe to kicking this season, if any?
Well, you know, right now, you know, Melo's only having one duty right now. And, you know, he's doing pretty good at that duty. So, you know, that's the good part about it. You know, in practice, he still does the punts and some of the kickoffs. But right now, his load is a little bit lighter, and he's just concentrating on one thing when it comes to game time.
How dangerous of a player is Brandon Isaac?
Brandon Isaac is a very good player. I had him in Calgary. You know, you have to, once he knows what he's doing and he's very comfortable, then he's a guy that you have to look out for. You know, he's a very good blitzer. That's one of the best things about his game is his blitzing skills. So he's a good player, and he's also a big talker.
And he's injured a few players.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's full speed now. Like I said, I don't know if it's malice or ill intent there, but B.I. is a very good player. He's always playing full speed.
Spencer Moore was tweeting this morning that he's about ready to make his debut in Hamilton. Is that your understanding of his status?
Oh, he is? Yeah. Good for him. He probably just means he's coming to the game. He might be flying to the game. He's a young guy that I hope to see do some good things. So, you know, he'll make the move up, so it'll be good to see him play and see what he can do.
Does he just go in for McHenry, or how does that
work? Yeah, he'll make a move for McHenry.
How much is an advantage? You're moving him to fullback, but he was a receiver in college, and that, again, versatility paying off.
He's a big dude. I'll tell you that. I just told Coach Dyson earlier, I said, he is a big dude, but that's one of the things, I think he's a draft steal if he can pan out, you know, because one thing we saw him play like some tight end, some fullback, more tight end and receiver when he's at McMaster. So him playing a little bit of receiver, a little bit of fullback, is very big to have those type of versatile guys. And I'm sure George, he's a good coach, and he knows how to maneuver guys with their versatility.